appropriate for her to make submissions to you about what the sanctions would be, and for you to consider those in the deliberation. And I seek leave to be able to do that. Result of what happened in 2009 and the way it's played out may be that the council expresses their view that Councillor Deeming should apologise to Mr Deeming. And she instructs me to say that is unlikely to happen from her perspective. She would have been absolutely happy to apologise. She spoke with me a couple about an apology many years ago. That request was refused, and since that time, there have been a number of events visited upon her by Mr Deeming. That means there is no goodwill between these people. Given that he ran a campaign in the newspapers only 2 years ago, trying to usurp her position as a councillor in an election year, means that she shouldn't be compelled to apologise, and she's not inclined to do so. The matter could have been finished much, much earlier with an apology, but that was declined. So in her own forthright way, she's advised me to instruct you about it, because she doesn't want to fail to fulfil any obligation you may make. But on the balance of things, in my submission, it is a cruel punishment for you to make her apologise, ask her to apologise for an event 9 years ago, when the actions of the complainant in the meantime have been most unsavoury towards you. But I think the main thrust of my submission, Your Worship, is that after 14 years of faithful and dedicated service, the finding of a breach of the code is in and of itself significant sanction.
so in some respects I do not agree with the no penalty that's been proposed, because the worst thing that can happen to Councillor Deeming, she ends up like me, a councillor on those subcommittees. It's not the end of the world. So I kind of think, hey, well, if we're to be centred actually addressing this in a manner that's, I guess, reflective of what we should be doing as district leaders, there's no penalty thing I can't support that.
I've got a slightly different opinion. The apology thing to me, it means nothing. I think a controlled apology is achieves nothing. The time thing, although it shouldn't, I don't think that can affect the penalty. For me, the appropriate penalty would be a binding which has breached the code, which we found, a retraining, which has happened, and the only other possibility for me is possibly of censure. I look at Councillor Deeming's behaviour and respect in this place since I've been here, and I don't believe that will be the case, and I will be happy to vote for an open appeal.
I won't be supporting the motion, Your Worship. I think it's unfortunate, but I do think that a penalty needs to be imposed. I have a great deal of time with Councillor Deeming. She's been really helpful to me as a new councillor, and I speak to her a great deal. But I do think I don't buy the passage of time argument on the basis of the passage of time argument, because this council did not handle it properly. And the reason that Councillor Deeming has been upset, I'm sure she has been, is because the actions were not taken when they should have been taken. I can understand, because of the bad blood, that it would certainly stick in the core of Councillor Deeming to make an apology. However, I think we have to try and get above that and the issue, and stick to the issue of people. And I think that this council should be instructing Councillor Deeming to apologise to Councillor Deeming. If he chooses not to accept it, then it says something about the character of man, right? But I think that this council should expect a councillor to apologise as a councillor for actions that were taken as a councillor.
But it is a long time ago, and when we were having lunch, I asked the question, who was on the licensing committee? And most people couldn't remember whether they were or they weren't, the people who were on the council at that time. So, to not remember is something that we're all going to get better at, I think. So, I think that I support what your worship has said. There's been retraining, that would be the normal process that we would go through, and significant upheaval to Councillor Deeming over the last 9 years, in fact, to both of them, over the last 9 years. But I think that this is the best way forward.
Maybe 9 years is a long time, maybe it's not a long time, but
There are things that happened with council today which we fall down on our communication, and I had to apologise to people in my community where our communication has fallen down. And so, I mean, I apologise on behalf of council today to Mr and Mrs Deeming for, you know, what you've had to go through and the impact it's had on you and your family. I apologise unreservedly because it's...
Oh, tēnā koe mō tō aroha ki a ia ki tōna whānau e.
So I'll just finish by saying that I hope that all parties can get closure after this today and move forward in their life. Thank you.
I'm a little bit concerned if we don't have some sort of formal closure today, that we will be back here next year and the year after doing the same old thing. So how on earth are we going to finish this today? Because it has to finish today. 9 years is a long time of people hurting each other. For what? For what? And what about the husbands and the wives and the children? You know, the whole community has suffered through two people with a blank, with the horses had those things up. Whether one's out to hurt one more than the other, I think is irrelevant. I think today it has to finish. It has to come to an end. And it has to come from the heart. So Mr. Deeming and Councillor Deeming need to say to each other, let's finish this now and put it to bed. And try to do better for our families and our community. Never mind about for ourselves, because that's the selfish part. I'm not going to say sorry to Mr. Cox. I'm not going to say sorry to Mr. Cox. It's not always all about you. It's about your loved ones around you. And I think if you can take it outside of looking at yourself and feeling, oh, poor me, and you both have a good reason to feel, oh, poor me. But what about your whānau? We have met them over the last 9 years. They've had to suffer through your anxiety, stress, tears, worry. I've seen it in here. Everything that's hurt, it's like that thing going like that inside your body all the time. So I left the quote at home from Mahatma Gandhi, but it talked about
This hearing is, I think I would have known that probably about 99% of the people talked about it and the intuition put from both sides. The point is, if you go back to the day when this first started, Courtesy of Chris Leitch was part of this debate, and if the attitude and the way we used to behave and cease getting information out and back to council was quite different to this debate. But nonetheless, you know, we've got to stand by that some of the basic principles. Basic principles, we had an initial complaint from the council, and through various resolutions, various discussions, been pointed out in the evidence given today, that there's a couple of main turning points. One in 2010, when Mayor Cuffler was first appointed, looked through the information and said there's no more need to continue this debate, but the matter be heard by the Privacy Commission, and he felt that it was sufficient enough. And then later on, it was referred to the Human Rights Review Tribunal, and they heard all the debate and all the evidence of Mr. Deeming, and he thought various things. After the full review of that, they decided that council should commit and pay $2,000 based towards plus expenses. So that's the outside organisation away from us hearing this with very experienced people, and that is deemed to be full and final settlement. Then it's come up a couple of years later again, 3 years later. You've got to understand why it was a need for that. You know, Councillor Deeming has previously offered an apology to the mayor, that one was accepted by the mayor. But Councillor Deeming did offer that apology at that time. And we've all got to remember that when you say about apologies, don't they? That apology went off for some time ago. We've also got to remember that prior to the last election, the intent that an advertisement was going to be made used at the prior election, what that is intended for. So I think you can put blame either way for the outcome, to certain things, but I've got to know how it's made. Three is to look at actually what was said, what was said, and what we do today. What the resolution does is states we've heard the evidence and we'll take no further action based on the evidence we've heard today. And that's basically where why I supported it. Because on balance, there is so much congestion, we can sit here for another 2 days and get on down to this hearing, all this information came. But when you get some independent people hearing the case and making recommendations and saying this should be either, and it's not, it's continued on for another 3 years, I think you've got to look at the reasons why. You look at our councillor, Councillor Deeming. She works in here, she was re-elected after the campaign against her. She was re-elected in the Greenway Ward. And I don't want to say too much, she had out-polled me. She was re-elected. But I've worked with Shelley for the government for all the years she's been on council. And this has a deep effect. I've seen her in situations where she's been distressed. And I think I've seen it closer than any of the councillors around here. And it's about the only one that matters. Yeah, she's a member of this. Both Mr. Dean and Mr. Dean are a member of the same community. So it's not hard, and I certainly can say this in first-hand experience. When you go to Roman stuff, the first thing they take you with is nothing about Roman, it's always about council stuff. So, you know, that is the stress of council Dean, you know, continue for the best part of 9 years. So that is why I want to make this quite clear that we want to leave this today.
Before I put the motion, I would like to just make some final comments. We're dealing with a councillor who has been a part of the council for a very long time. She made a very poor error of judgment some time ago. If that councillor had continued with that sort of behaviour, then I would have no question in saying that we should throw the book at her. But in my experience, since that time, Councillor Deeming has performed her duties according to the oath that she swore. no intention of changing that, and I don't think that's an appropriate penalty. We could have perhaps requested an apology, but as our legal counsel pointed out, it's not part of the censure, part of the penalties that are in our code of conduct. So that's not an appropriate request today. Censure could have been, but I have moved that because of the passage of time, and I accept that that doesn't nullify the action at the time. That's why we have upheld the breach of the code of conduct. We are saying to Councillor Deeming that was inappropriate to breach the code. We've upheld that. But since that time, there have been no actions or inaction on behalf of Councillor Deeming that I can see that would require any penalty to be imposed, which is why I moved that today. I apologise to Mr. Deeming and Mrs. Deeming for the fact that you have had to fight for what you believe was this day, the hearing today. But I am proud that this council does and has taken this action. We are the only authority who can decide whether or not the code of conduct has been breached. We are the only authority who can decide on what penalties, if any, are